Sometimes I stare at the wall, and in the back of my mind, I hear my conscience call, telling me I need a girl who's as sweet as a dove. For the first time in my life, I see I need love. There I was, giggling about the games that I had
played. What's that shit? And I'm a... Come on, Wi-Fi.
Yo, I didn't mean to hurt you before, you know.
My bad, Sean.
When I'm alone in my room, sometimes I stare at the wall, and in the back of my mind, I hear my conscience call, telling me I need a girl who's as sweet as a dove. For the first time in my life, I see I need love. There I was, giggling about the games that I had played with many hearts, and I'm not saying no names. Then the thought occurred, Gia drops me, my eye lit, because I said to myself, look what you've done to her. I can feel it inside, I can't explain how we feel. All I know is that I'm never dishing of the raw deal, playing make-believe, pretending that I'm true, holding in my laugh as I say that I love you, saying no more.
Let's see y'all share the live from me.
Whispering, I love you, and I
share the all your friends. It's not COVID, I promise. Make sure y'all share this live, alright?
So, tell me how your tour is going.
It's a real thing.
Saying it's real successful.
I'm the love doctor. It's a real thing.
Just as real happy, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Interviews, girls
real.
Calling me all the time.
Yo, that's real thing, man.
See what I mean?
Hello, girl, today. Listen, what I tell you about these rap guys, huh? Hey, look, I have
to lie from y'all. To the lie from y'all. To the lie from me. To the lie from me.
Sheer delight. How sweet. I gotta find me a girl to make my life complete.
To the lie from me. To the lie from me. One time. One time. One time.
I'll lay down my jacket so you can walk over a puddle. I'll give you a roll. Pull out your chair before we eat. Kiss you on the cheek and say, oh, girl, you're so sweet. It's deja vu.
Hey, I'm done.
I could go on forever telling you what I do. But where you at, you need to hear
the lie from me. To the lie from me. To the lie from me.
Classic
right here.
You told me to Atlantic City, I make it up.
We gonna get started real soon. Waiting on some more people to join live. Where is Buck when you need Buck? Buck. Where you at?
See what I mean?
Exceliano, what it do?
Such a revelation. It's taught me love and how to be a real man. To always be considerate and do all I can. Protect you, you're my lady and you mean so much. My body tingles all over from the slightest touch of your hand. And understand, I'll be frozen in time. Till we meet face to face and you tell me your mind. If I find you, girl, I swear I'll be a good man. I'm not gonna leave it in destiny's hands. I can't
not
sit and wait for my princess to
arrive. Hey, he was singing his heart out on this one. Oh, wait.
I need love.
Okay. I need love.
We
just getting started here. Waiting on Buck. Waiting on Buck. Do I got people on here?
When I be sitting in my room all alone, staring at the wall, fantasies, they go through my mind, and I've come to realize that I need true love, and if you want to give it to me, girl, make yourself seen, I'll be waiting, I love you.
All right, what's going on, party people? How y'all feeling out there, man? Welcome back. I'm glad to be back, man. Brit Love is here. You know, we had to take a quick break last week to participate in the Blackout Tuesday. But we back, so I know y'all been missing the show, live in action. Make sure y'all share this live to all y'all friends. Because tonight, we're going to be talking to three single ladies. And I also have a special guest for y'all tonight as well. So I need y'all to share this live to all your friends, to your exes, your currents, your sidelines, all that good stuff. Go ahead and share it to them and tell them to tune in. If anybody has Buck number, call Buck and say, Britt said do what you were supposed to do. That's all I need y'all to say, all right? And also, we're going to follow up soon with some couples, you know, that I made, potential couples. And I also got some new potential matches, all right? So once again, if you want to sign up to be on the show, make sure y'all send us a DM to @GirlsNeedLoveTuesdays. You know what I mean? Because this here, this thing right here, this show right here, it gonna keep going on, goddamn, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So if you single and you ready to mingle, I might be able to find you a little boo. Yeah, the sidelines, you heard me? Send us all your friends, though, to live and whatnot. And we're going to get started, man. Where are my people at? All right, look, Alex, I know I gave you the second slot, but the first shawty is not here. She didn't answer. Call that girl one more time, Danya, please. Call her again because she's supposed to do something for me very important and she's not here, which means that she's letting me down as a best friend. All right, Alex, we're going to go ahead and start with you because the first girl, she's not in here. So, Alex, go ahead and send me a request and we're going to get right on into it, all right? Girls Need Love Tuesday, each and every Tuesday with Britt Love, your favorite love doctor, okay? Make sure y'all follow @GirlsNeedLoveTuesdays. Alex, send a request to get on the live. Can everybody hear me too, by the way? Is the volume good? Is everything straight? Straight, strickety, that. Alex, join the live, baby. I'm going to be at the shallow, baby. I'm going to just sing. It's okay. I sent your request. Just go ahead and accept that. It's okay. All right. There you go. Yo, you ain't never went live with somebody. You talking about?
No, I never went live before with anybody.
I'm talking shit. How you doing, though?
I'm good.
All right, so just thank you for going first, man. I know you were supposed to go like second, but thank you. Everybody, go ahead and make some noise for Alex. Welcome her to the show. Girls Need Love Tuesday. You know what I'm saying? Thank you for signing up. You know what I'm saying? We're going to go ahead and go. First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go over your bio that you sent me. All right? And then I'm going to ask you a few questions so I can get to know you a little bit more, okay?
Okay.
All right. So this is Alex, everyone. She is 24. She says she is 5'4". You reside, or you from Covington, but you live in Fulton. You're a Sagittarius, currently a meat clerk. You identify as a stud. You're looking for either a femme, stem, or no label.
Yes.
Correct. All right. And you say, I'm looking to meet someone goofy like myself. Someone I can enjoy quality time with, and someone to hopefully spend my life with. I like to cook. I love movies and crime shows in the mountains. Hold on, crime shows, that's a trigger right there. You be watching
like Law and Order SVU.
Oh, okay, I thought you meant like How to Get Away with Murder. I'm like,
nah, I don't really watch that no more.
Oh, no more. Oh, okay, so we over. Okay. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get into your question. So the first question that I always start off with is why are you single?
My last relationship didn't go well, so I decided to stay single to work on myself because I know I have problems myself. I have flaws.
Okay, and that's big of you to admit that, man. I respect that. And how long have you been single?
I've been single since my birthday, actually, in December.
You broke up on your birthday?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I did it.
You did it?
Yeah.
Also, like a birthday gift to yourself.
Yeah, pretty much.
I like that. Okay. Now, what was the reason for, besides, you know, wanting to focus on yourself, what was the reason, like, what was not going so well with the relationship?
From the beginning, it started off toxic, and she's that type of female that like to put her hands on people, and I'm not that person.
Okay.
Because when I put my hands on somebody, I black out.
Okay. Got you. And how long were y'all together?
Probably about 4 months.
4 months?
Yeah.
Okay. So that was short.
Yeah, very short.
That was short. Okay. physically and mentally describe the type of person that you would like to date.
Physically, honestly, I don't care the type of person they are. I just need them to have an amazing personality.
Okay.
I need somebody that can sit there and understand me.
Okay.
So, and when things go bad,
yeah,
they know how to handle it.
Okay. Can handle when it goes left. And no physical things that you like most about a woman that you don't like about a woman.
I mean, I have one type, and it's big girls.
Okay. BBW. So,
yes.
That's what's up. Hey, I love BBW, so I got a lot of respect for them girls. They be walking in their confidence. I'm all here
exactly.
For it. I'm all here for it. What do you value the most in a relationship?
I value trust.
Okay.
Because if we can't trust each other, then that's a problem.
Okay. Value that trust. Now, how would your ex, I heard what you said about your ex, but what would she say about you? If I asked her, you know, like, about Alex, what would your ex say?
She'd probably call me an asshole. I'm going to be honest.
Sagittarius are assholes. Y'all can be assholes. Y'all are good.
I'm an asshole. But I'm nice. But I'm only an asshole when an asshole presents himself to me.
Okay. Say keep that same energy. Keep that same energy.
That same energy. Yes.
Energy. Okay. All right, and you value that trust. All right, so pick one word that you would use to describe yourself.
I am an adventurer.
Adventurous? My bad, what'd you say?
Yes. Adventurous. I'm an adventurer.
Hold on, wait. Little baby in the background. Sorry, what'd you say?
Kennedy.
Kennedy. Kennedy.
She's trying to crack the ball. Kennedy. She tried to grab the phone and everything. Oh, here she comes. Here she comes.
Kennedy, how you doing? Hey. She said, I want attention, okay? All right. I didn't hear what you said, though. You said you're adventurous, right?
Yes.
Okay, adventurous. So you, how do you, are you LGBT? Which one of those are you all?
Like.
Lesbian.
Oh, I'm a lesbian.
Trans.
I'm a lesbian, I mean.
Hold on, Alex. Listen. You sure?
Huh?
You sure? You talking about I'm a bi? I mean, I'm a lesbian.
No, I said I was a lesbian first. I just got tongue twisted.
No, I'm talking shit. Don't mind me. I'm ignorant. All right. Do you believe in ignorant? I mean, see? Ignorant as fuck. Do you believe in marriage and do you want to get married?
I believe that marriage is something that takes time.
Okay.
And will I want to get married one day? Hopefully.
Okay.
If somebody right comes along.
Okay. But it does take time, but is that something like you believe in? Like, do you believe in?
I need somebody to take it slow with me because I'm a very quick person. I jump in relationships.
You fall easily.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, that's not good. I mean, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? All right. Is that your kid?
No, that was my actual cousin.
Okay. Hey, look, cousin Kennedy. Do you want kids? Do you have kids?
I don't have kids, and I would only try to have a kid once. That's it.
What do you mean by that?
Because it's like, I want a kid, but I don't want to continue after that first time. Mm. Like, if I had one or a set of twins, I'll be fine after that.
So you just want one kid?
Yes.
Oh, I thought you meant like, if some, I don't know, I thought something completely different. Okay, got it. All right, is sex important in a relationship?
Sometimes.
Okay.
But it's like, I'm the control freak for sex, so it's like, it doesn't matter if you're not good or not.
Yeah.
As long as I know what I'm doing. And okay. You're happy.
Okay. Alex, you put it down. And knows how to put it down. Okay. That's what's in my notebook. Have you ever cheated?
I cheated once.
Let's talk about that.
My whole life.
Let's talk about that. Was it like in the past, like recently? Like, let's talk about when you cheated.
It was like a year, almost 2 years ago.
Okay.
And I got caught up. I'm gonna be honest. Yeah. It's like I got caught up with the fact that she was an older woman.
Oh, we had a little cougar.
Yeah.
Damn. You know what? I fuck with cougars too, man. That's salty. Did that cougar like that.
They ain't all right.
Why? Because like the sex wasn't good or like she went home?
No, that was the abusive one.
Oh, the toxic one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So yeah. Ask you this. Why cheat? Why not just end the relationship? If she's toxic, if she's domestic, why not leave? Why cheat instead of just leaving?
I didn't cheat on her. I cheated with her.
Oh, my bad. So you cheated with the toxic one. So you definitely ended up getting your karma.
Yeah.
Hey, karma ain't no hoe.
Karma
don't play. I'm trying to
tell you. Karma. It got handed to me.
Hey, karma don't play. Okay.
Exactly.
Which of your personality traits, if any, would you change about yourself?
I would change how I talk to people. Because sometimes I can come across as too blunt or too much of an asshole when in my head it's something completely different.
Okay. So gotta learn, like, practice, like, to think before you speak and not act up your reaction to your emotions.
Exactly.
Okay. Okay. I respect that. That's a big thing for you to admit. What do you do in your free time?
I don't have much free time.
Why is that?
Because I work too much.
Okay. Workaholic.
But other than that, I either would be cooking or watching movies.
Okay, like cook. You keep saying that. You must get thrown down because when somebody keeps saying they can cook.
I've been cooking since I was 12 with my father.
Yes,
and he's actually a pastry chef. Like
that. You said what?
He's a pastry chef.
Oh, okay, that's what's up. So it's in the family.
Yeah, it's in the family.
I know how to cook. I just know how to make, like, noodles, you know, box foods, you know, just simple shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm not that person, all right? So do you drink or smoke?
I do both.
Yes.
But I don't drink as much as I smoke.
Do you smoke the ciggies?
Not anymore. I'm putting that down.
Good. Good for you. Now, is your partner allowed to smoke?
To cook? To smoke or drink?
Yeah.
They can do what they feel like. If they don't smoke and drink, they don't have to. I'm not going to smoke around them. I'm not going to pressure them into it. I mean, it'd be nice to have them try it every once in a while.
You seem like a very respectful person.
Yeah.
Liking what I'm
I respect saying. Everyone's boundaries.
That's what's up. What are some of your pet peeves?
My pet peeve. My pet peeve is when somebody lies to my face and I can sit there and tell you that you're lying to me and you still continuously lie to my face. Mm. My other biggest pet peeve My other biggest pet peeve is when things aren't in order.
Disorganized?
Yes.
Okay. Are you like a neat freak?
Not at all.
So you
it's just certain things have to be in certain places.
Okay. Certain things like what?
Like, say for instance, I'm at work, right? And we're closing down. People put things in places they're not supposed to.
Okay. I follow you.
And I have to sit there and go behind people and redo a whole thing over again.
Okay. I understand you. Keep it in order.
Keep it in order. Keep it the way it was.
Got it.
Don't change.
Got it. So, what are some of your biggest goals in life that you want to accomplish?
One day, I hope to own my own business.
What type of business?
A catering business.
Okay.
Well, it's also like a restaurant / catering business.
Okay.
And
let's be specific.
I want to join in like DoorDash and Grubhub and stuff like that. Like, all the fast food restaurants has.
That's dope. That's dope.
So I want to take it everywhere.
That's lit. I respect that. What's your favorite movie?
My favorite movie.
Mm-hmm.
John Wick Chapter 2.
John Wick? Chapter 2?
The second movie. Yes.
I don't even know. I ain't about to act like I know what that is, boy. John Wick. That's the dude with the guns?
Yes.
Neo?
No, he played in the movie with Common.
I don't know.
You gotta watch it. There's like three different movies.
I'm gonna look it up, try to get a better feel.
They call him the Baba Yaga.
The Baba Yaga?
The Boogeyman.
Oh.
Because you don't see him until it's too late.
Oh, they saying it's lit. I gotta get hip to this. I don't know nothing about it. All right. What's your favorite type of music?
I like all different types of music, but the one I listen to most is old school.
Okay. Old school, like R&B, rap?
Well, R&B, old school rap.
Okay.
Just the old school genre.
That's what's up. I love some good old school music. Okay? I'm trying to tell you. All right. What would you constitute as a perfect date for you?
Perfect date? Something very simple, mm-hmm. like a movie date and then dinner afterwards.
Okay.
Or we cook together.
Okay, back at it again with the cooking. I'm trying to tell you. Make me a plate, Alex. Shit.
I'm skinny and I like food.
Okay, that's a blessing. But look, you're still young. That shit gonna catch up to you now. You might want to be careful. I'm trying to tell you.
Yeah, I know. You just been catching up fast enough.
I'm trying to tell you. That's what's up, though. All right, now, do you believe in love at first sight?
No.
Okay.
Not at all.
Okay, absolutely not. All right, last question. What does love mean to you?
Love is a bond. It's something that is built. The longer you build it, the stronger it gets.
Okay.
Till it becomes an unbreakable bond.
Okay. I like that. Are you prepped for this question? Okay.
No.
People get a little tongue-tied on this question right here. You had that down pat.
Because I know what I want to say when I answer the question.
Let's go, Alex. Okay, that's the Sagittarius in you. Well, look, mm-hmm. I actually think I got somebody lined up for you, depending on how I feel when I re-look over their notes.
I'm okay.
Gonna have you a match. All right.
Okay,
y'all make some noise for Alex, man. Thank you so much for being on the show.
No problem.
I'm going to follow up with you like tomorrow or the next day afterwards. Don't quote me on that, but you will be followed up with.
Okay.
All right. See you later. Appreciate you.
See you later.
All right.
All right.
What a sweet girl. Just the sweetest little thing, right? Just so sweet. Alex, the Sagittarius. Just sweet. Just so sweet. All right, we're going to keep it moving with our next guest. The password ain't work. You ain't typing in right, but come on, Shasta. Shasta. Am I saying your name right? I'm getting cold feet now. You didn't decline my little message like I FaceTimed you. You declined my FaceTime or something. I was about to say, what's up, girl?
Hey.
I'm like, what's going on? How you doing?
Good.
Did I say your name right? Is it? Oh, let me fix my camera. Is it Shasta?
Yeah, Shasta.
Okay, everybody, Shasta.
Hey.
How you doing? Everybody, welcome Shasta to the show.
Thank you.
Huh?
Thank you.
Oh, what'd you say?
Thank you.
No problem. My computer, my shit, every time, like every Tuesday, shit be hating. I'm like, you trying to fall and stuff like that. All right, so how you feeling this evening?
Great. You?
And thank you so much. I'm great. Thank you for asking. I'm good. Thank you. Come on, Manners. All right, so I got your bio up right here. We're going to go ahead and get into it. Is that your real name, by the way? Is that a nickname?
No, that's my real name. You know, it's from a soda.
From a soda?
Uh-huh. And it's a mountain, and it's a flower.
Oh, deep. Multiple meanings. All right. So you say your name, Shasta.
Yes.
32. You're a Virgo.
Yeah.
Woo! Virgo. Currently front desk agent at the Marriott. Let me get a discount.
Okay.
Girl, quit playing. Also owner of Waste Beads. Okay, handmade, period. You are from how you say this?
Corinth.
Corinth, Mississippi. Never heard of it.
Right.
You are currently residing in Dallas, Georgia. How far is it from Atlanta? It's close, right?
Like, depending on traffic, maybe like 40, 45 minutes. Depends on how you drive.
Okay, cool. And you just moved here in November. Mm-hmm. 420 friendly, period. You like to drink Fireball. Yuck. And then you said, I'm looking for someone that's consistent, honest, and loyal. Mm-hmm. Trustworthy, loving, and caring, and outgoing. Looking to travel and explore things with that person. Looking to build each other up. They also have to have a relationship with God. Amen. Someone that has goals. Amen. I'm fun, loving, and silly. Hardworking young lady. I love to smile and laugh. That's dope. Good vibes. I'm big on working out now. Love to cook. Doesn't matter what or what time. I'm also a clean, neat freak. You got OCD. That's me too. I got OCD like a motherfucker. And you want to get the feeling of somebody, like texting, like FaceTime, be wanting to see you like an affectionate young lady. Okay, so you very affectionate. You need some attention. Okay, yes. Be all up on me. Okay. All right, so first question that we start with, why are you single?
Well, because, you know, I moved here, so we didn't want to do the long distance relationship, and it wasn't working out anyways. It was toxic. But I have... I got a question first before we go all into this. Do you think it's better for me to, you know, try to look for someone even though I'm new here, or try to get to know people, or what?
Oh, the tables have turned. You asking me the question. I say take it slow with Atlanta, because coming to a new scene, you don't know anybody. Let alone do you know anybody who might know that person. So now you don't even have nobody to ask, like, yo, what's up with this person? So I would say take it slow, really try to get to know these people here, these women here, because, you know, some people have a different agenda. Some people come with baggage. That's why I say when you sign up for the show, I don't want you to have any baggage. So I would just say have your fun, because it is going to be fun dating. It's going to be very fun. But just be protective of your heart and just take it slow.
Okay.
That's what I would say.
Okay.
All right, now, how long have you been single?
Well, I moved here in November, so really like September.
Okay. Now, that's still fresh. Are you over your ex?
Yeah, we don't talk, nothing. We don't do nothing. Text, none of it. And she's back in Mississippi anyways.
Okay. Now, let me tell you something. Toxic is it's a wide range of toxicity. So, like, what kind of toxic was this ex of yours?
I say, like... toxic, like it wasn't working. She'll listen to her friends instead of, you know,
So communication?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Poor communication. Single since September of this year. All right. Physically and mentally, describe the type of person that you would like to date.
I mean, long as they have something going for themselves. And,
okay. Okay, go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead. You're right. Go ahead.
Going for themselves, they got to be consistent, you know.
Okay.
Loving, a family person, because I'm big on family, because it's only me and my sisters left. So, like, I like being around my sisters and, you know, that they family.
Okay. And physical wise, do you have any? Nope. Now, don't be saying that, because y'all love being like, I don't got no type. And I match them up with somebody, then they be like, oh, that ain't my type. So.
Well, I mean, I done dated all. Huh? I mean, I would like them my height, but, you know, I'm like 5'2". Okay. So, yeah, I would like them my height. But I done dated all from film, studs. I haven't dated a STEM, which that'd be, you know, probably a little different.
Okay.
But, yeah, I done dated both.
Okay. All right.
I ended up in long-term relationships with studs, though.
Okay.
One was a 9-year, and then one was like a 3. Yes.
What happened to the 9-year? Let's talk about it, girl. You can't just walk past that. You can't just sell that and just, girl, let's talk about this 9-year. What happened? That's a long time to get somebody.
Yes, it really is. And, like, to this day, we're best friends. Like,
oh, that's good. Yeah, I like when it, if it don't work out, I like when y'all can still be cordial friends, whatever it is, you know what I'm saying? No bad terms. Mm-hmm. I like that. All right, so what do you value the most in a relationship?
Mm. Honesty.
Okay. Mm-hmm. That's what's up. Now, if the shoe were on the other foot and I was to call your ex like, yo, Shasta, what you got to say about her? What would she say about you?
That I always go back to my ex, as in talking wise. Like, I always, like, she didn't want me talking to her. But it's like my best friend, like, my mama, like, you know, welcomed her. My mom welcomed her, you know, with no problems. So, like, she knew my mom and stuff like that. When I say knew, I mean my parents are deceased. So, that's, you know, I feel like, you know, my mom was real close to her.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because she welcomed her in our home with no problem. So.
Okay. Yeah. So, y'all still, where y'all at today? This ex that you be going back to, y'all still cool? Is there any hope for y'all? Any hope for y'all?
Nah.
This the 9-year relationship?
Yeah. And we both was Virgos.
Virgo on Virgo. Woo! I can only imagine. Okay. Describe yourself in one word.
Outgoing.
Okay. Are you full-blown lesbian, bisexual, no label?
Lesbiana,
okay. Do you believe in marriage? Do you want to get married?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Yes to both of those, marriage, and wants to be married, period. All right. Do you have kids? Do you want kids?
No kids. Do not want them.
Why you don't want kids?
I just don't. It takes, you know, I don't want to go through the pregnancy. Like, no.
Mm-mm. Girl, I'm trying to tell you because I don't want to mess with this body. I said, if there's any way to have a kid without a fucking out this body, oh, I'm for it. But until then,
I'm already working on it. Like, no.
Okay.
No.
Mm-mm. Okay. But what now? This is the thing. Like, what if you get with somebody, like, they got everything, but they want kids? Would you be open? You would be open to at least adopting?
Yeah.
Okay. That's fair.
If we was like that serious, we had to get like married, and I would do, you know, the injection, that type of thing. Yeah.
Okay. That's what's up. Compromise. Mm-hmm. I like that. All right. Now, one of the key questions, is sex important in a relationship?
Well, I mean, I've been here this long, so not right off it might be, because I've been here this long without it. So,
okay.
I mean, as long as we do like 2 or 3 times, you know, 2 or 3, you know, I'd be fine with that.
Okay. So you ain't had no sex?
None.
So you horny? I'm fucking with you. I'm fucking with you. All right, sex is not important, but at least 3-4 times, what, a day, a week, a month?
Week.
A week? Mm-hmm. Okay.
I don't use, you know.
No toys?
Well, the strap.
A UV.
Yeah.
That's nasty, girl. Okay.
And the tongue. I like, you know. Yeah, I like
and the tongue. Okay, got you. All right. Have you ever cheated?
I mean, talking, flirting, but like sexual intercourse, no.
Okay, see that? But sometimes, I don't know, that little talking, flirting, that's kind of, that hurt a little harder than the sex. I don't know. Yes. Never cheated, but entertained. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I mean, at least you're honest about it. All right. So, which of your personality traits, if any, would you like to change if you would pick anything about yourself?
What would I like to change?
If any.
Being so open, because I, you know,
okay,
it tends to hurt people's feelings.
Okay. I respect that. You got to definitely be careful with that one.
Mm-hmm.
What do you do in your free time?
Right now, I'm working on doing my waist beads.
Okay.
Yeah.
Those little things are so cute. I might start wearing them. You ever seen a stud wear them?
No.
Am I going to be the first stud?
Yeah.
Give me some waist beads, girls. Let me wear them things. I like my waist snaps. Let me wear that shit. All right. Do you drink or smoke? Well, you said 420 friendly.
Mm-hmm.
Do you drink?
Yes, but the only drink I like to drink is Fireball.
Literally just Fireball. That's crazy. But you know what? You from Mississippi. So that sounds like about like whiskey, Mississippi. It just seems like some type of relationship. I used to love Fireball. That shit cheap, but it didn't get you fucked up. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I can just drink it straight. That's the only liquor I can drink straight.
Girl, you say you're trying to work out, right? You got to change from that whiskey. You got to change. You got to get a little tequila song. Because that whiskey, that's heavy on the soul, like syrup. Okay? You got to change that. All right. So what are some of your pet peeves?
Oh, if you're not clean.
How you gotta, like the house?
Both. Okay. I was just going to say that. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So no dirty, musty people. Got it.
No. House, really? I mean, even car. Yes.
Okay. Oh, I can't. Oh, I'll be cleaning my girl car. I'm trying to tell you.
You know, they say it goes off your car and your bathroom. Them two.
That's true. That's true. I will say that. So, what's your one biggest goal in life?
One biggest goal is my business.
Okay.
Yeah. Because I just have more than waste these that I want to do.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
So what else do you do with the business?
Right now, I just do the waist beads and ankle bracelets and necklace. Anything they just ask for, really, I just do it.
Okay, that's what's up. That's different. All right, so what's your favorite movie?
Well, I don't have a favorite movie. I have a favorite series.
Okay, what's that?
The L Word.
Oh, Lord. I never seen it. And Brandy was watching that stuff, and
it was pretty good.
It was real gay though. It was like lesbian. I'm like, yo, they gay. Like,
yes.
It's like a porno though, kind of. Because I'm like, they keep fucking. Every time I look up, they fucking. It's just, and they nasty. I'm talking about fists and all kind of shit. That show was crazy. It's a big porno. All right, so what would you constitute as a perfect date?
Mm-hmm. Well, me, anything, because I'm 9 out of 10 always doing, you know, the surprising, like the cooking, decorating the rooms for the films and studs. So if I just get a basic meal, you know, something like that, I'd be fine with that. Okay. Or at the park, a picnic.
Okay. Y'all, look, you know what? One thing I noticed, everybody come here talking about picnic. Like, are y'all for real?
Yeah.
Or y'all just saying it because it sound good.
No,
when you go to a picnic, it's bugs, it's hot, it's sunny, you know what I mean? Like, I like picnics, but do y'all really like that stuff? Okay.
Well, or I can do the sip and paint.
Okay, sip and paint. I like them.
Mm-hmm.
I like them thing. All right, go. All right, do you believe in love at first sight?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay. You ever went through that?
Nope.
Okay. So how do you believe? What makes you believe in it without experiencing it?
Because I can see somebody and be like, yeah, I want this to work. And I would try, you know, which I have. I'm not going to speak on anybody's names, but I have been in a few of your friends, you know, inbox.
Ooh.
Yes. I inbox you and let you know.
You gonna tell me who you was in their DMs?
Yes. And they just look past me. Yes. But I see them in the comments now.
Oh, they in the comments?
Mm-hmm.
Oh! Well, what'd you say in the DM?
You know, I just, you know, I don't mind trying to shoot my shot. I don't mind at all. No, I approach a female in a minute. And yes. And I just try to, you know, throw my little shot and they'll look over me.
Hey, you win some, you lose some. Mm-hmm. But Pop said you live to fight another day. Okay? It's okay. All right. Last question. What does love mean to you?
Love me to me. That's a hard one. That's a tricky one.
Yeah, I know, right?
Yes. You gotta be genuine, you know. I gotta, you know that you're genuine, you know, about me.
Okay.
Yeah, I've been through a lot, so.
Ain't we all? I'm trying to tell you. But most importantly, is knowing someone is genuine. That is true. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, I got everything I need here. I actually, for you too, I actually think I might have somebody lined up. Don't worry about my friends when hit you back. Most of them ain't shit anyway. I'll tell you that. They good people. Relationship-wise, they ain't shit. All right? So don't worry about it. All right?
Maybe well, they were single. They're single.
Oh, my bad, huh?
They were single. They're single. So, mm-hmm.
Don't even worry about it, sis. Make some noise one more time for Shasta, y'all. Don't even worry about it, sweetheart, okay? You better show them titties. Let them know. Say, okay. All right, I'm going to follow up with you tomorrow. I'm going to follow up with you tomorrow or the day after.
Okay, thank you.
All right, thank you. All right. Okay, she said, if y'all don't remember nothing, y'all going to remember these titties, okay? She said, when I leave this show, if you don't remember nothing, you're going to remember these things. Okay, I'm fucking weak. All right, so, Chris, you are funny as hell, distracting me in these comments. All right, so I told y'all I have a special guest for y'all. So I'm going to go ahead and join her on. Miss Vida in the building, Venom, you know what I'm saying? Let's get it. Let's get it. Let's get it. Hey, hey. What it do, Pimp Juice?
What it do? What it do?
What you doing, nice. Sir? What's good? Everybody, welcome me to Venom to the show.
What it do? What it do? What it do?
How you liking the show so far? How you liking the show so far?
Yo, this show is crazy. Y'all are definitely like going off right now. Yeah, it's definitely.
Yeah, funny. Yeah. So we doing something special today. I got a special guest in the building. You know what I mean? This is a first-time thing. So you are actually starting off this trend right here. You are the innovator right here. You know what I'm saying? So go ahead and introduce yourself. Let people know who you are, what you do, where you from.
Hey, yo, what's good? My name is Vida Venom. I'm a female rapper. I'm from Washington, D.C. Yeah, no.
From Washington, D.C.? Okay.
Yes.
All right. Yes, yes. And this is a love show.
Okay.
So it's only right that I talk to you about love and some of the music as well, but we're going to talk about some love, okay?
Okay, we can talk about love.
how's your love life?
Oh, man, my love life right now, it's like bittersweet.
Okay.
I respect it.
The answer. Okay. So what are some relationship tips that you would give? Because these people that come on my show, they really looking for some love, okay? Mm. And lesbian relationships, you know, they really different, you know what I'm saying? So what are some advice that you would give to some fellow lesbians?
You know, trust your instinct. Always go with your gut feeling. Mm. Chin up or the crown slip. You know, and... You know, I don't know, you know, stay focused for real. I mean, I'm not that person to get into relationships.
So. Yeah. What are you like? You would rather be working versus...
I am a workaholic, okay. But I mean, I don't personally feel like working should stop a person from, you know, pursuing love if that's something that they wanted to do.
Right.
You know, any and everybody make time for what they want to make time for, you know.
That's true. Now, do you run into issues with being in the industry and, like, have you ever dated someone that's in the industry?
No.
No?
No.
Okay. Is it hard dealing with people who are not in the industry and them trying to understand you working and being busy and always on the run?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Definitely is. And I'm a Gemini.
Oh, you a Gemini. Oh, yeah.
I'm a Gemini. I just had a B-Day. Yeah, I just June 4th. Yeah, I'm definitely a Gemini.
That's my best friend's birthday.
Oh, yeah. See?
Yeah. I fuck with Geminis.
Good love.
I fuck with Geminis. Okay?
Good love.
All right. So, if you don't mind me asking, do you date females?
I do. I'm pansexual.
Yes, pansexual. Okay. Let's talk about it. For people who don't know what pansexual is, because people don't know what these labels are and they want to claim it, what is pansexual?
So, as a pansexual, I don't have a preference. Like, I self-identify as an aggressive femme, meaning I am attracted to submissiveness. And I've dated trans, both going male and going female. You know, I'm pretty open. You know, pansexuals don't really have preferences in what they date.
Okay. Now, how did you even find out, like, about pansexuality? Like, what? How did that even... How'd you find it? Did you do your research? Because I've heard about it, but I'm like, what is
I did my research on top of, you know, what I, how I live and, you know, the type of stuff I be into and stuff like that. Like, you gotta be able to, you know, put your money where your mouth at and okay. You know, self-identify out here, you know.
Okay. Now, pansexual, they ain't got nothing to do with being, like, poly, right?
Nah.
Okay.
Nah.
I don't know the difference. I'll be getting confused.
Now, see, poly people, they like open relationships. It's like a couple who got, like, they be out here doing their thing. So, like, if I'm locked in, I'm locked in. If I got a girl, I got a girl. I'm not about to be out here. Like,
no. I respect that. What do you know the difference between, like, polyamorous and poly? What's the other word? It's like polyamorous and poly something. Probably I know it's one where it's like, I had a friend who told me, like, she was poly. And her girlfriends thought she was cheating on her. But I'm like, well, if it's an open relationship, how the fuck can you cheat?
Right, right. I think it's something to do with, like, the other partner knowing about it or something.
Yeah. Yeah.
Polygamy, that's what it is. I ain't with none of it.
Okay. Yeah. All right, so I like to ask this question to everyone that comes on the show. Some people get stuck with it. So for you, Ms. Vita, what does the word love mean to you?
Word love.
Yeah, love.
No boundaries. The word love to me is, wow. It's a very strong word. I don't think that's something that a person should just pass around.
Period.
Being as though it can be used for multiple and different reasons, I'm gonna assume you mean for a person. So for me, love is where you can't think, eat, or sleep, you know, without knowing if a person's okay or what they doing or have they thought about you or how they day went. It's giving R&B vibes over here.
Okay.
I'm
feeling it. You broke it down into spoken word shit, okay? I'm feeling it, okay? So are we able, can we get some bars for the people? Can we get some bars? It can be written. It can be.
I was about to say, I just wrote a poem. How about that? Y'all want to hear this poem?
Yes.
I just wrote.
Yes, it's perfect.
It's given, right?
Let's do it.
Let's get it.
Let's go. All right. Everybody, make sure y'all got y'all snaps ready.
Yeah, snap. So it's called Still, right? It's called Still. Long drive. Thinking about everything, yet thinking about nothing. Clouded. My mind's racing. Heart steady. Broken. How does one heal? When I keep replacing my healing with people, places, and things, not allowing myself to feel hurt. But I'm so blinded and indecisive. I'm so focused on all the wrong things. I'm still hurt. So I attune suddenly only to feel and realize it'll forever be pain weighing heavy on my chest. But chin up and head high. And all you can ever do is your best. But I'm still hurt. Still.
Damn! No, I fuck with that. And you know what? Sometimes I hear poems and I don't understand that shit. I understood that. I understood the message behind that. What inspired you to write that?
I'm actually going through a little song right now, you know.
Okay, so that's basically how you feel currently.
Yeah.
Okay. I actually love that. I love that. That was deep. Okay. Thank you for coming on to the show, man.
Absolutely.
Let them know where they can find you, where they can check out your music.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Once again, my name is Vita Venom. That's at Vita, V-E-E-T-A, Venom, V-E-N-O-M. And that's on all streaming platforms and social media. Make sure y'all go cop that new single. It's called Message. It's out on all streaming platforms. You can cop it on my pages. I'm linking my bio for the video. Thanks for all of that.
Thank you. Hey, y'all make some noise on my time. Vita Venom in the building. Y'all be about to cry and shit. You ain't tell me
what's
coming with that energy. God damn.
Indeed.
All right. Thank you, man. I'll follow up with you. Appreciate you.
All right.
Woo. Palms hit. Hit the soul. Y'all like poetry? I got a poem for y'all. Y'all want to hear me? I ain't got no fucking poem. I wish I could write poems. You know what? One day I tried. I was on an airplane. And I was like, man, I want to write a poem. And I wrote a poem. I'm trying to find a post for y'all. That's the only poem I wrote. In high school, I used to write haikus and shit. Say, no, I don't even know what haiku is no more. All right, so we have one more guest. Where she at? Where she got cold feet? I think my last guest might have got cold feet on the kid. I don't see her. Her name is Desi. Desi, my man. My girl, sorry. What up, Rico? Thank you. Desi, if you are on my live, please shoot me a request. This thing is gonna cut off on us exactly at 9 p.m. So we have 10 minutes. I might just talk to y'all and fuck with y'all because y'all be in the comments going crazy. So say something to me, y'all. What y'all think about the show? Give me some feedback. What are some things that y'all dealing with right now in y'all love life? Like, what are some issues that y'all are dealing with when trying to date? Like, what's the issue? Like, talk to me. What's some issues y'all having with y'all love life? What is it? Are you the toxic person? Are you willing to admit that you're the toxic person? Talk to me in the comments. Chris, you want to get on here? Thank you. Thank you. Y'all can, if y'all want to really make me feel good, y'all can send me a little tip on the Cash App. Chris, get on my live real quick. Hey, now.
Oh, shit. I'm already on live. I ain't gonna get that
all week. So you've been going crazy. My bad.
Give me an update. Real good job today. Somebody calling you. That's
mama. Oh, no. Nah, that was my, it was saying my battery died.
Who it was? Oh, I thought, who it was calling?
No, nah, that said my battery
was
dying.
Don't want to tell us, huh?
No, that's what my baby was at. All right, I promise. So, what's the things that y'all was talking about in the comments? Break, because I couldn't read everything. So, break, give me a recap of the comments.
I don't know. I was rolling the blunt and it was seizing it, and I had got.
I saw that.
I had to tell everybody. I put it on the wrong person page, but I think you did a really good job today. I felt
thank
even
you.
With the comeback because we was off last Tuesday, you did a really good job with the questions and stuff today. I thought
thank you
just a little bit more in depth. The questions be good, but they was more in depth. I
thank you
today.
Thank you. Like that.
I felt like we got a little bit more out of people.
Yeah, I agree. So let the people know what's going on with your match that I matched you up with.
You know, unfortunately, I feel like, you know, it's going to be a no for me.
Why is it a no? Do you mind? Because I'm just trying to give some feedback from my...
Yeah, you know, I can put it politely. You know, it's just getting to know people. I feel like first impressions are lasting impressions. Okay. We kind of plan to link up a time or two. And it fell through both times, not on my part. And I don't like stuff like that because I just feel like, you know, I'm a person who's very...
Keep your word.
Keeping my word about where I'm going to be. If I say I'm going to do something, you know,
I'm going to
do
it.
I feel like, you know, I'm firm believing you make time for the things you want to. So, you know, I don't know if it was maybe a nervousness or something like that or anything, but it kind of did put me in like a, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, that's me. So,
damn. I didn't know that. So thank you for explaining that.
Yeah. It wasn't that crazy, you know. Like, you know, she was nice and everything. You know what? I was hoping to get the chance to link up, but it's like, you know, if it moved from this and then it moved from that, and then we supposed to link up this day, and then the next time we're supposed to link up that time, and then we don't link up.
Hey,
it's like, you know, I can't be waiting for the link up.
Inconsistency is not good. Yeah. They said, what are you matchmaking? I'm matchmaking lesbians. They said, what are we matchmaking? My bad, I was reading it. All right, well, you wrapped that up and summed it up. And
I just want to make sure I put my
thanks for the honesty and the transparency and being very respectful with how you put it.
Nothing wrong with our girl at all, nothing like that. And then hopefully when we do get to see each other in person, we can chit-chat more. But who knows when that will be.
Hey. I'm going to still try to find somebody, because you know what? I fuck with you. I love your energy. I love you as a person, period.
Period. I appreciate it.
I'll talk to you later, my dog.
All right,
yo. Be easy. I love that girl, man. You know what? Christina is a good girl. She is an entrepreneur. She is a beer connoisseur. Yeah, I should rematch her. I definitely am. You know what I'm saying? Because I like her. You know what I mean? And that sucks that her match was blowing her off, and I wish her match was on here right now so we could really get to the bottom of it. Matter of fact, somebody call Kiera and tell her to get on here. Or Melanin is, I'm sorry. Somebody call Melanin and tell her to get on here. I'm about to get Yoni on here real quick, and we're gonna talk just for a second because we only have 5 minutes, alright?
Yoni. Hola, mamacita.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Muy bien, gracias. ¿Y tú?
Muy bien, ¿cómo te va? ¿Qué estás haciendo? That's it, that's how you got it.
Hey, that's how I pass Spanish class. Just that little conversation right there. That's the end of it. How you feeling?
I'm good. Yo, the show is mad cute today.
Thank you. This is Yoni. This is one of my first guests, or like second round guests. Her match didn't really work out well, but I got faith in you too. I ain't forgot about you. You know what I mean? I just don't want to mess up the match. So I'm taking in your feedback. And then, you know what? Nobody got to actually hear your part, okay? So just to give y'all a recap, I matched her up with Tiff Cole. We all spoke with Tiff Cole, and, you know, we heard what she said. Basically, did you hear what she said?
I didn't hear it. I wasn't on live that day, but a friend of mine told me.
What'd your friend tell you?
Basically that I guess I kind of like scared her off or something, because I happened to go on live the soon after yours. So I saw that she went on mine. And so I said something to the effect of like, oh, hey, potential bae or something like that.
Yeah.
Why won't you come on live? And then she like threw some heart eyes and dip. So I'm just like, all right. I mean, to be honest, it didn't really matter to me, because I know I said I was open, but I realized I probably should have been a little bit more specific, because I did say I want to try something different.
What you asked for.
Exactly. So I meant like, you know, a femme. Because I like, me personally, I like zaddy vibes. Like, you know, I like a dominant person. Like,
okay.
So, she was more like the homegirl. And cool. Like, she's cute, but definitely no daddy vibes for me.
Okay. She also said that she wanted you to slide into her DMs. But I kind of feel like you saying get on the live was kind of like.
I think so. I mean, I think so. Yeah, like, you know, I see you here, so what's up? I'm initiating conversation. Mm-hmm. So I don't know.
Okay. Well, for someone who just admitted, like, you know, be more specific in saying what you want, let's talk about people kind of saying they're open to things, and then you get
okay, so let me be exactly. So I am open, you know, and I said I mostly date like studs and stuff, so I am open to femmes. I probably should have said that, like, you know, I think she's like a stem or something,
like a stem,
you know. And my thing is, I want to always be, you know, the girl. We can both be the girl together, but I know girls, I saw the comments who were saying femmes can be daddies too. I know that, but I wasn't getting daddy vibes from her. That's just where I'm coming from. You know what I'm saying? Like, she, like,
yeah,
I said, she
gave energy, though. I'll tell you that. Like, she.
I mean, I didn't get to see it, so I didn't get to initiate it. And I tried to initiate conversation with her, so not much big, thick energy there. Like, not that I didn't get it. It was a little.
No, I'm just being petty. I'm petty as fuck.
Yeah, so. I mean, because to me, a big dick energy would have slid in that motherfucker. Like, what up? You know what I'm saying? Like, yes, I don't care if you're ready. I don't care if you're not. Like, that's daddy right there. That's daddy. And so, like I said, daddy, that's the homie. She could be the homegirl, but definitely not that.
You keep saying homegirl, and I'm just so fucking weak at that comment. At the homegirl comment. Okay. Well, also, Yoni has been helping me with casting, and I definitely appreciate you for that. So,
no problem.
But also, I still need to find you a match too, even though you kind of helped me with the process now. I still got.
All right. So let me just narrow it down, because obviously I confused you
before the live, because I was 45 seconds to tell you.
All right. Yeah, I want daddy vibes. So if it's a femme, let's just stick to either femme or stud.
No,
not really, not really into like the stems, not really my type. And I do want somebody taller than me. So like 5'7" and up, you know, that's preferable. Because nigga is short. I'm 5'4". So
I'm gonna try my best to find somebody.
All right.
I appreciate you. We got 10 seconds. I'll talk to you later.
Bye, babe.
All right, yeah. All right, everybody, man. I appreciate y'all for tuning in. Make sure y'all send me a tip if you were entertained tonight. Make sure y'all follow us. DM at Girls Need Love Tuesdays. We want to sign up.